Good evening and welcome to GMIT Student News. On this evening's bulletin, we will be discussing a topic that has been a constant debate since the introduction of the HPV vaccine in 2011. HPV infection causes up to 420 cancer cases per year, and of these, 130 die from the disease. Most of these cancer cases are preventable with the vaccine. Of these, around 300 cases are in women, and 90 of these die from the disease. So as you can see from the graph, there is a sharp decline since the introduction of the vaccine in HPV-associated cancer in females. So let's take a look at what is HPV. HPV, the human papillomavirus, is caused by a non-enveloped double-stranded circular DNA virus. The virus is roughly 55 nanometers in diameter. Most infections are harmless, but about 30 types of HPV may lead to cancer. Genital HPV is the most common transmitted infection with more than 40 known types. It can infect both males and females in the genital areas. Most notable HPV types 16 and 18 can cause low-grade cervical cellular changes, high-grade cervical cellular changes, and cancer of the cervix. There is also evidence linking HPV with cancers of the anus, vulva, vagina, penis, mouth, and throat. HPV mostly affects sexually active females, however, it can cause genital warts and cancers in both sexes. This evening we are joined by leading medical scientist in the field, Dr. Rebecca Salmon. Welcome, Rebecca, to GMIT Student News.
Thank you for having me here today, Megan.
We are very excited to have such a well-known name here in our studio. Rebecca, I've already given a brief introduction as to what HPV is. Could you elaborate on this to help our understanding of the topic?
Of course, Megan. So what you said is entirely correct. HPV stands for the human papillomavirus. It's non-enveloped, double-stranded and circular in its DNA. So it's transmitted through close skin-to-skin contact, primarily during sexual intercourse. And the HPV virus itself doesn't actually cause symptoms, but it gives rise to warts, genital warts, cervical cancer. And it's when these exist that symptoms occur. So in the case of warts and genital warts, they're often clear up on their own. And if not, they can be treated with creams, lotions, specific chemicals, heat, or removing them through freezing. If they're left untreated, genital warts can cause problems, especially for men in urination, if they block the urethra, and they can also cause bleeding to occur.
And so where does cervical cancer play its role in relation to HPV?
So HPV types 18 and 16 primarily cause cervical cancer in 70% of cases. So the symptoms of cervical cancer include irregular or abnormal bleeding after sexual intercourse, bleeding between periods, back, leg and pelvic pain. And as the disease progresses, symptoms would develop further. So treatments in the early stages would include comb biopsy and laser therapy to remove abnormal cells. And in advanced stages, as the cancer progresses, radiotherapy, chemotherapy and hysterectomy are advised.
So as I gather, it can be quite an aggressive cancer.
Yes, very much so. It can cause penile, anal, vulvar, oral and throat cancer, as you mentioned, and probably more cancers that haven't yet been further studied.
And finally, Rebecca, are there any other preventative measures to reduce the likelihood of contracting HPV?
So in order to fully prevent yourself from contracting HPV, sexually transmitted HPV, is to abstinence, which is unrealistic. So they recommend that you limit your number of partners and to use protection during sexual intercourse. And for females, it's essential that they attend regular pap smears to check for abnormalities in the cervix.
And as I've already stated, the vaccine is the main form of protection. Do you have anything else to say on the subject?
Well, it's important to note that in Ireland, the Gardasil vaccine only provides protection against type 6, 11, 16 and 18 of HPV. So it wouldn't cause protection for the rest of them. And it was introduced in 2011, as you said, and it's offered to girls in their first year of secondary school. And it's important that, in my opinion, that they get the vaccine to provide protection, but it's entirely up to them themselves.
Perfect. Thank you, Rebecca, for taking the time to enlighten us and better our knowledge
No problem, Megan.
Of the human papillomavirus. That's all for today. Thank you for listening.